Yeah, hi guys, today we are going to discuss about a simple code generator or a code generator. How exactly the code generator is carried out? What are all the internal operations are essentially required for the code generation? How it is happening? A glimpse, it's not exactly a glimpse only all the time we are discussing in the compiler design. When you go for post-graduation, there is compiler design will be there, computer science and engineering, especially those days. Nowadays, MTech, lot of fascinated courses have come. So those days we used to study MTech computer science also. So again, compiler design will come, but that would be much more advanced level than BTech level, what you study. So by the time you may be knowing better. Now all are preliminary level only we are discussing. So first, no longer needed, remove the name. In which code generator, register allocation is majorly primary concern. How to store the data into register, how to read the data, how to use the data from the register, and how we can determine the register is live. The data live means the data which resides in the register may be referred in the subsequent session. So it is essentially required to preserve. So that is the meaning live. So which are all the variables are not in use, when to remove, these are all the major considerations involved in the code generation phase. Now, how it is helpful, how it is doing is primarily based on basic block. Basic block is the primary concern or required. So that basic block of three address statement is given as a input to the code generator. Then basic block after the code optimization naturally can be said. Then output would be target language. What are all the procedures or methodologies, operations involved? There are three steps. It's a generator we are calling, simple code generator. What is the input? What is the process? What is the output? Input is a basic block, because locally, piece by piece or step by step, sequentially we need to move, so that the entire block of instructions or fed as input to the simple code generator. Then there is a processing will be carried out. So during that processing time, cost calculation, instruction selection, whatsoever the issues we discussed in the previous session, those all the topic fall into or fit into code generator. Using those all, it generates finally the machine instructional code or assembly level code, mainly assembly level code. That assembly level code is used as machine readable or executable. Anything which we are trying to execute, that assembly output of this simple code generator has been used. Now let us see one by one. One small analogy only we are going to consider, nothing more. A small piece of information, that is, suppose at a statement I, statement I means what, at a statement number 1, statement number 2, something like that. So let us consider there is a statement 1 or I, x is equal to y, operation z. What is OP is operation. That's all, nothing more. Normally you will do know y into z, y in y plus z, y minus z, something like that you will do. So x is equal to y operation z. We attach I, the liveliness, and the next uses of x, y and z. If you look at compiler design, even for error notification, primarily it uses the line number. Line number is primary concern when it comes compilation process. Even for user communication also, it uses line number 20. There is no variable assigned or there is no variable declared. It is multiple declared. These are all the announcement or summary report it gives. So line number is here important to understand those variables x, y, z, which these three are involved. Liveness. What is liveness is how many variable, how far in the program it is required for the future references. Maybe line number 10 in your C program, you may be doing x is equal to a plus b or c is equal to a plus b. How many more lines that values need to be stored in the register? That is a primary concern, because the cost of moving the data to the memory to the register is costlier affair, or more time consuming, or more resources required, something like that. Suppose that variable is used frequently in the subsequent statements of your program, or rarely used, but it is just. So how to deal those two cases? So that is what the primary concern when it comes code generation. May audible? Yeah, sometime internet goes down. Look at here. For that purpose, this IE is attached. Now we are going to look at one by one. In the simple table, set X to not like and no next use. When we can set this not like or no next use? If the X is no more, it is required. If it is required only, it will use this as it is required. Otherwise, it's set. See, look at here. We start the last statement of B and scan backwards. Attach the statement I, the information currently found in the symbol table regarding the next use and liveliness of XYZ. If it is there, if it is not there, it needs to mark it as zero or something, not like no next use. Ultimately, the indicator of liveliness of the variable or of the register is indicated through flag indication. That's a flag bit. Flag is it's a kind of fast processing register, we can say, one bit register, we can say. So the flag register will indicate with the binary zero. If one is available, liveliness is there. That for variable definitely would be requiring in the forthcoming execution or flow of your program. If it is set as zero, no more it is required. Then what is the meaning is the register content is updated to back to the memory and it can be relieved. The register can be relieved for the utilization. Now let us move on to the example. Look,
ma'am, I am unable to see the screen, ma'am.
And next use of Y and Z to I, X, Y, Z, all the three are used. Not like no next use. How we are writing this is based on your programming context. For the exam point of view, you can write anything. There is no sequence is required. You can, X is equal to Y plus Z, we have put. So Y and Z are live because right now it is activated for the use of loading the data or computing the operation. Once the operation is done, the data will be stored back to X. If the X is no more use, utilization is available in the entire programming sequence, it will be marked as not live, no next use. If it is utilized in the forthcoming statement, it will be marked as live. Which statement it is used again? Maybe 40th statement. This may be used in 50th statement. You may be working in 10th statement. That's it. Simple, very simple. Implementation part you may feel very tough, but a theoretical notion only this much. So X is equal to Y plus Z. Let us imagine instead of plus, they have mentioned operation. X is the variable, no more it may be referred, so that it is marked as not alive. If it is not alive, not used, not useful. If it is live, first you need to deduct whether it is need to be retained as a live or not. If it is supposed to be retained in the liveness, then liveliness, then what you need to do? You need to put forth the statement number, which statement going to be referring these variables further. That's all. So very simple. You can write any statement. You can illustrate this. Next. First step is ready. Next step, you may need to identify instruction selection. What is instruction selection? Let us look at. So before instruction selection, yeah, the flow is going right only. Let it be. So now we are going to look at instruction selection. This itself, I brought to your notice in the previous session itself, yesterday itself. So what is this? Always adding two register content will be the cheapest instruction. Rather than cheapest, when we used to study microprocessor, what is the way we used to study is instructional number of cycles required, number of machine instructional cycles required. So 2-byte instruction, 3-byte instruction, then number of instructional cycle is 2, number of instructional cycle is 4, number of instructional cycle is 6. This kind of instructional cycle only it is attached for us. What is instruction cycle? Then next you need to understand. So we in the gate examination also, this question is expected. As a part of compiler or as a part of microprocessor, it is mandatory to have this question. So you need to find out number of machine instruction cycles involved for the given piece of assembly level code program. They will be giving you piece of code. So you may need to calculate number of machine instruction cycle, or sometimes they may give the machine code. Then you may need to optimize. Then after the optimization, you may need to calculate number of machine instruction cycle utilized for that assembly program. So these are all the questions we'll be expecting. So that based on that instruction cycle only, we are trying to tell cost is 1, cost is 2, cost is 3, etc. Yesterday, as I mentioned that there is no money transaction, dollar, rupees are not involved. The cost is number of machine instructions required, or instruction cycle is required, or execution time based on execution time. Instruction cycle is almost execution time only, indirectly to say. So this one, always adding two register contents, the cost involved is very lesser. Next, one is going to become your memory reference, another one is register, then the cost is much more higher, in which the cost is going to become much more higher. How it is higher is moving the content of memory to register, then adding two register content will become much more costlier affair. That's it. See, already we have mentioned any operation involved with one memory, one register will be bit costlier. Two registers are one. So look at just roughly, there is one memory, one register involvement, and there is one more full of register involvement. All together, what you will be having, the cost will become more for this. That's it. Register and address descriptor, these are all the two data structure majorly used in this program code generator, program code generator, are also in the register allocation. Let us try to understand theoretically. I have brought plenty of examples in order to understand these two data structures. Register descriptor, register address descriptor. Instead of data structure, what I can say is it's a kind of indicator, that's all. There is a variable internally utilized by the compiler. Those variable will keep track of the information about something. It refers something. That is called data structure. Even a tiny variable int I is also called data structure. Please understand. The moment data structure means, don't think too complex definition, linear data structure, non-linear data structure, something like that. So any primarily, the moment you use primary memory, this also I addressed in the previous sessions. The primary memory, whenever you are concerned about, that is called data structure. Whenever you are concerned about secondary memory, that is called database. If you are interested or working targeting the secondary memory, it is called database technologies. If you are interested to target for primary memory, it is called data structure. Now, what is register descriptor? It is used to keep track of the variable stored in the register. Initially, it will be empty. Always, which variable is stored in which register, that indicator is called as a register descriptor. For example, the first instruction in today's class which I discussed is x is equal to y plus z. Suppose you are moving the variable y to one of the register R1, then register descriptor of y is R1, where y is available. R register holds which variable, that's all. So address descriptor, register descriptor, more or less same only. The terminology only will differ. For example, what is register descriptor is, it will talk about what value is held in register. What value is held in register, or whose value is held in register. That is register descriptor, whose value. What is address descriptor? Which variable is loaded to which register, vice versa. That's it, nothing more. It's a simple, I will through example you can able to understand. So now let us look at, for example, location may be register, memory address, or stack. It can be anything. Now quickly let us go through one of the example through in which you can understand better, then I will come back to the function. Most of the time, get register is the function used for assigning the register to the variable. In your program, definitely whomever writes a program, every one of you will have lot of operations, lot of variables. So how it is mapped, which variable is mapped to which register, so that value is called, that operation is carried out by get register, assigns the register to the variable. This is the primary role of this get reg function. It is essential that for each and every one of our variable, a register is available. The entire story I have narrated in the previous session, why registers are important. It is the only data structure or internal component can communicate with CPU. CPU is like a VIP, VVIP in the computer. So who is the next VIP to communicate to the VVIP? Only the registers. So it is mandatory to store your variables to the register. Even though you do small operations, C is equal to A plus B, those variable values need to be loaded into the register. Only then register can communicate to the CPU all along with the instruction for the execution. So in order to do that, we may need to first primarily allocate the register for the variable. That register allocation to the variable is carried out by get register. That's all. It's a simple function. Now let us move on to one of the instruction through in which you can understand. Then I'll go back to this theoretical notion. Look at here. A casual or conventional way of doing programming code, D is equal to A minus B plus A minus C plus A minus C. This is what you are intended to do, let us imagine. Now how this piece of code is executed, it will be converted into three address code. 1 minute, I am trying to fit in that page so that you can refer, vice versa. No, I'm not able to fit. So look at here, D is equal to A minus B, A minus C, A minus C. So how it is, this is optimized code. T is equal to A minus B, U is equal to A minus C, V is equal to T plus U, D is equal to V plus U. It is translated into three address code representation. After this three address code representation of the original one, it is a kind of temporary variable, temporary variable, temporary variable. So through the temporary variable, it is optimized code you are trying to obtain. After this optimized code, how it is going to become internally, or what is the role of the code generator? So look at here, this is going to become input to your code generator phase. This is what the expected output. If you are passing the instruction assembly level code called T is equal to A minus B, your code generator need to give this code as an output. Move A comma R naught. A is the first variable, is moved on to the register R naught. Second time, sub B comma R naught. The variable directly expected to add, subtract, involved in the operation subtraction or not the register. One of the variable memory location and another one is the register. So there are two different components are involved in both of the instruction. So this instruction, definitely you can claim that costlier instruction, let it be. Now here our part of the understanding is, what is register descriptor, what is address descriptor. Look at here, R0 contains D. What is available in the register is indicated by register descriptor. T is in R0. R0 is T. T is available where the T is loaded, to whom T is given. That if you look at it, it is slightly ulta. That's all. R0 contains T, T contains R0. You can write the vice versa. So here primarily you will be talking about register. Register contains what you are writing. Here T is available in where you are writing. T is available in R0. You can write D is available in R0. D is available in R0. U is available in R1. U is available in R1. T is available in R0. That's it. So where this is available, what it contains. Hope so you would be understanding what is register descriptor, what is address descriptor through this example rather than the theory. So far now we discussed, this is a high level English like programming structure fed by the programmer or user. Then the assembly code or three address code or intermediate code generator, or after the optimization or without optimization. See, with D live at the end. D is live at the end. So D is expected to involve only at the end. So till then, it is not required also. After this, depending upon your programming style, it is decided whether D's liveliness is required or not. The next, there are four components you are articulating or you are trying to understand. One is the instruction, intermediate code instruction. How the equivalent assembly code will be generated. Already we discussed that there are three types of code can be possible to generate by code generator. One is fixed memory location, relocatable memory location, and assembly code. Among these three, popularly used, widely used, as I mentioned, it is assembly level code. So now we are discussing how the three address code, the intermediate code or three address code is translated into assembly level code. While converting it into assembly level code, two more data structure involved. Now you may be understanding, instead of executing one compiler, how much memory references are internally occupied. They are telling garbage collector, they are telling garbage collector routine that is parallelly executed, parallelism is achieved. Then they are telling that other data structures, temporary variables, symbol table, then entire compiler routine itself need to come and sit in the primary memory. All the memory utilization is expected. So register descriptor is what is contained in the specified register. What is address descriptor? Where is available any of the variable? It can be any variable. This is temporary variable T. It is also a three address code. I need to call it as a variable only, TAB. So the variable is available in which register. That's it. Now let us go back and understand the theory concept again. So now you may be able to understand. Register descriptor is used to keep track of what is currently in the register. That is what your primary concern. Address descriptor stores the location where the current value of the name can be found at the runtime. That's it. So you can write whatever the way you understand, you can write. For this or this kind of operation, assigning the register to the variable, get register is the function used. That's it. There are two data structures used. That is register descriptor, and already I mentioned about it, register descriptor and address descriptor. Much more detail also given. So let us consider this example. X is equal to Y operation C. OP stands for any of the operation. It can be arithmetic operation or it can be special logical operation. Anything you meant to give here, or relational operation or bitwise operation. Any of the operation you may mean to give here. Now look at, if you read the statement, it will be absolutely collapsing you. But rather, if you look at this example, definitely you can understand, grasping 100% is for sure. So let us, I try to attempt for you. See, whenever descriptor for any variable they are trying to tell, they are using the complement. That's it. Address descriptor of Y is Y complement. y dash something, not complement, y dash, that is a indicator. Then what is the meaning is, prefer the register for y dash. We need to prefer the register. If the value of y is currently both in memory and a register, if it is available, let us take for example, y is a variable, the value is available both in memory and the register, what you need to prefer? Prefer the register. You need to prefer the register. That is what they are telling. Why you need to prefer the register? Already one piece of information I have demonstrated. Always the instruction which has full of registers will consume lesser instruction cycle, or cost is lesser. If one of the memory, one register, the cost is more. If both are memory, the cost is much more. Now, if the value of y is not already in L, generate the instruction. You need to generate this instruction. If it is not available in the specified location, you need to generate. That's all. Nothing more you may need to understand here. You need to generate the instruction based on the descriptor. You need to find the location. L meant for storing the result of the operation. Now you can decide. L can be register, or L can be memory. Which one you prefer for the lesser cost of the instruction? Naturally, you should prefer only the register. That's all. Prefer a register to a memory location. It is given here. That's it. Nothing more you need to worry. You just understand what is Y complement. It is a descriptor, address descriptor. Next, you need to find out Y is whether available in the memory or in the register. If it is in the memory, you need to prefer to work with the register, so that you need to generate the instruction move off based on the Y descriptor to the designated location L. Here L can be anything, your choice. It can be a memory or it can be a, what to say, register. That's it. Here nothing more you need to worry about here. Look at one more example. Generating code for indexed assignment array, single dimensional array, one dimensional array, two dimensional array, some kind of array indexed references or instructions. How the code is generated? Let us have a glimpse here. If you look at here, A is equal to B of I, A of I equal to B. Move B of Ri comma R, the cost is 2. What is the meaning you mean to say? This I, index variable, that index variable always it is referred, because index is the primary concern, the memory something. So that B of Ri, so B and location, that index variable, there is a register, special register, index register is available. You can go through the microprocessor. Because array has frequent access of that memory deck. Array is a what? A collection of memory location reserved for homogeneous data representation. So I, that index variable, constantly involved in order to refer the data point. Because of that, always the index variable is used in index register for improving the speed of the execution. Index register will have the information about base address, incremental value. Then the moment the trigger comes, immediately or quickly it will increment. That is a special design for array handling, that is called index register. In it is available. So that what we are trying to do, B, array name or starting address of the array we are giving, and the index register we are inviting or we are calling. The next is what? You can move to R. The first step is simple assignment, no? So that you can move to R. The cost is 2. Next statement, you are going to assign value B to AFI. So that what you are doing, B comma, a small, simple B means here we can understand in terms of starting address of array. A B comma A of Ri, because it is array indexing involved. So B comma A of Ri. This is the way you can represent for the array type of instructions or instruction having array access. So whenever you look at array, the moment you look at array, you try using the array name. Array name is what here? B. Here what is array name? A. Then you need to designate index register. So you don't know what register is meant for index register. So you are signifying with array. What is the index value you are using? That index value. That's it. Nothing more you need to worry of this. Next is pointer assignment. Whenever pointer operations are specified by the user, you may use pointer operation or pointer coding. By the time how you can use is the point of discussion. Look at here, A is equal to *P*. Content of the memory location P is given to A. Value which is available in A is assigned to address memory location P. So this is what memory location of P, address pointer of P. Now move *RP, A. What is the meaning is, this RP stands for pointer register. These registers are exclusively meant for handling pointers, indirect addressing technique. In microprocessor again you have indirect addressing technique is exactly representing the pointer values whenever pointer comes into the picture. *RP, A. Next also what? *RP. This is a special register meant for address handling, so that you need to mention RP. This is what code generated, output of code generator. This is what input to the code generator. You are slightly analyzing about the cost involved or instruction cycle. Next, how the code is generated for if condition, conditional statement, compare, CMP. This is what assembly level instruction. We used to have compare only. Compare X, Y. If conditional jump, CJ stands for conditional jump. Upon this condition, CJ is less than Z means what you need to go. CJ is less than, you need to jump to Z. Otherwise, you can move to move Y, R0. That's it. So look at here, if X is less than, go to Z, add Z, R0, move R0, X, conditional jump is less than Z. So this is what the way code generation or assembly code generation happens for any of the conditional statement. Next, peephole optimization. This we have discussed already, but here when it comes machine's code instruction, it is termed as peephole optimization. Machine architecture dependent, machine dependent optimization, it is peephole. More or less the concept of optimization is here also. Earlier, machine independent with respect to source language, for the front end optimization, if you are trying to do, that is machine independent. For the back end optimization, if you do, that is machine dependent. So here, peephole optimization, why we are doing the same discussion in the previous session? To improve performance, to reduce memory footprint or memory utilization, to reduce code size. So these are all the merits, improve performance or execution speed. Whichever the language you feel so comfortable, you can try it. Memory footprint or memory utilization. So whichever you feel comfortable, you can use that. Now, peephole optimization technique. Redundant load and store elimination. What is redundant load and store is, look at here, y is equal to x plus 5. I is equal to y. Next is z is equal to I. Moving y to I, then moving I to y, then finally computing z into 3. The optimized code is here. Y is equal to x plus 5. How you can think of this? I is equal to y. You can avoid the entire utilization of z variable itself. W is equal to y star 3. Next, constant folding. The last session we discussed return. With return, I discussed return 5 plus 3, then return 8. Here, what I am discussing, x is equal to 2 into 3 if it is available instead of computing this during the execution time. This need to be computed during the compilation time itself. This is constant. We no need to wave. It is, we are not dependent on any of the varying nature, so that the compilation time execution is much better. X is equal to R. Strength reduction, this also we have discussed in the previous session. Strength of the operator, the cost of executing multiplication is costlier than cost of executing addition. So multiplication operation need to be replaced by repetitive addition. Similarly, the cost of exponentiation is higher than cost of multiplication. So exponentiation operation need to be replaced by repetitive multiplication. So these are all the two operations we need to consider in the strength reduction. Majorly, popularly, right from my BE, I'm doing these two only for strength reduction. There is no other technique they will be discussing, theoretical notion. So initial code x is equal to y is equal to x into 2. That can be replaced by x plus x or the bitwise shift operation. X double, that's all, shift operation, shift one bit left. Right shift always increase, multiply. Left shift always will decrease, that is reduction. Left shift will multiply. Right shift it will do division. So one shift operation will lead to one time multiplication. Similarly, one right shift operation will lead to one time divided by 2, one division. So this is what, multiply by 2. So you can use any of these two since it is 2. If it is other number, definitely shift operation will not work. Anything to the power of 2, if you are trying to attempt exponentiation, or if you are trying to attempt by 2 division or multiplication, shift operation will be helpful, highly helpful. So next is initial code x divided by 2. Now we are doing right shift operation, one right shift, that will do. So this is much easier or lesser instruction cycle involved than this. Next, algebraic simplification. What is this? Is always you can eliminate this by x is equal to x plus z. How you can eliminate? Just you can initialize x is equal to x. Because why to do that computation? It will waste your time. No, x is equal to x. So whenever you see this kind of operation, x plus 0, x into 1, you can replace it by simple LHS equal to RHS. X is equal to x, x is equal to x. It will be efficient because this need to go for computation. CPU will compute. CPU cannot sense whether it is 0 or 1. Our brain can sense. So that one instruction cycle, lot of load, lot of movement can be avoided. Directly x is equal to x we can replace. Here also we can replace x is equal to x. It is much faster. Null sequences, useless operations need to be deleted. Unreachable code, this also we discussed. Unreachable code, dead code. Combine operation, loop jamming. This is example, the best example is unreachable code, dead code elimination. This is what the previous session I was addressing. Then next is dead code elimination. These two operation, you can write the same theory which you learned in the previous unit, previous topic. Now combine operation, loop jamming. You can write the best example. Loop jamming is much better. Several operations are replaced by a single equivalent operation. For this, you can think of something, or if you are feeling not comfortable, just replicate what we discussed in the previous topic, loop jamming, unreachable code elimination, dead code elimination. With that, I'm stopping here. Only one more topic left out for your sixth unit completion. That is, what is register allocation and register assignment? What is register allocation? Is input program may demand n registers. Allocator need to give m number of registers. It should be supposed to be less than the available register. That is a primary role. It is a kind of optimization, minimization algorithm. Objective function is to minimize number of registers utilization. You can think of dynamic programming, greedy programming, choice is yours. Or you can develop any algorithm of mixing also, different paradigm also. But ultimately, it is an optimization technique. It is meant for reducing the number of registers utilization. As per your number of variable, it may be demanding this much, but you need to reduce. How we are reducing that, or what are all the strategies involved in register allocation and assignments? So this is what the topic left out, that we will be shortly addressing by 2:15 only I can handle. As I mentioned earlier, you can join back by 2:15.